Spread over 170 hectares, Pearl Valley is set against the stunning backdrop of the Dragonstein Mountains. Named Best New Course of the Year in 2005, it's a bold challenge for any golfer and has played host to the South African Open on three occasions. Pearl Valley is a golfing complex just an hour from Cape Town in the Valley of Paarl.
As you can see behind us, I mean, this is just one snapshot of what's available here at Pearl Valley. I mean, it's just amazing. In my opinion, Pearl Valley is one of the top 10 locations for a golf course in the world. And I'm including that all golf courses, whether it's Pebble Beach, Turnberry, St Andrews. They all have their own special place in history. But I think Pearl Valley, from a scenery point of view, is absolutely in the top 10.
Pearl Valley Golf Estates was officially opened in 2004 and boasts a 500-home gated community. The residential values have increased dramatically since its inception.
What I have been keen to do is to develop the club culture here, to give the permanent residents and the part-time residents a sense of having an extended home.
The current Jack Nicklaus course has attracted plaudits from professionals and amateurs alike since it was first opened. A trip around the course soon shows that Pearl Valley offers a stiff challenge for golfers of all abilities.
Well, Pearl Valley is one of the most beautiful golf courses, definitely in the country, if not the world, that I've seen. If we're looking at challenges for the golf course, the wind plays a very big factor here at Pearl Valley. We usually get the southeaster, and any visitors to Cape Town are very familiar with the southeaster wind. Today we've actually got the northwester blowing, and that's an unusual wind, and it actually makes the golf course very difficult, especially if we look at some of the holes into the wind on the front nine.
The 6,800-metre layout has been designed with the prevailing winds in mind, the winter nor'westerly and the summer south-easterly. There are nine lakes and no shortage of the typical Nicklaus bunkers, shallow, long and not too daunting. Let's begin our tour at the very start.
It's actually a very nice opening hole. Usually with the south-easter wind that blows, it plays downwind. So the players would probably be hitting 2-iron, 3-iron down there, leaving themselves about a 9-iron into a reasonable green. If the northwester blows, then it makes it a little bit more difficult. The guys are going to be hitting driver to a very tight fairway and making their approach a little bit longer. So it's a very interesting opening hole.
Survive the first hole. It's time to get the driver out at number three.
Again, we've built two new tee boxes on this par five, creating a lot more length. And into a wind like this, it makes it very difficult to try and hit a very narrow fairway, leaving a layup second shot and a reasonable approach into the green for the third.
We find an unusual hazard behind the green, but common to Pearl Valley.
Well, we've actually got a fair amount of flower beds around the golf course, and flower bed coming quite close into play on the back of three, so you've definitely got to leave a good distance for your third shot in there into the approach, so you create the amount of spin that these players are going to need. It definitely is a tough green to hit.
Let's jump to the ninth hole.
To be honest, it's probably one of the best finishing holes in the country. But saying that, it also works out nicely for the ninth hole. And again, depending on the wind, I mean, we've got the wind blowing a northwester today, so the players can be going in here with a driver 9-iron, driver wedge. It's 443 metres. So when the wind turns around and it blows the southeaster, which most of these players are probably going to experience this week, it makes for a very good finishing hole to a great front nine.
On to the outward nine, and it's time to loosen up and open those shoulders.
13th hole, this is another one of our signature holes. It's a par five. We got a water feature that actually makes an S shape the whole distance of the hole. And the tee shot's really everything here. To lay it up into an almost island fairway, and then a good approach into a very well protected green with bunkers on the right and the water running the distance of the green. The green is right on the water, so you don't want to spin it too much. You can definitely spin it back into the stream there, but well protected with bunkers and a beautiful hole to play. 17, par four, one of our most difficult holes on the golf course. The drive is everything here. You've got to set yourself up for a very difficult second shot, all over water, and you could be leaving yourself anything from a 5-iron to a 6-iron into a very well protected green with water all in front running down the left-hand side. You can very easily hit banks there and roll back down into the water, well protected also with bunkers on the right.
Now to Pearl Valley's ultimate test.
Par five, 550 metres. Again, we've introduced a new tee box here on 18. And unless you're Angel Cabrera, you're not going to be getting up in two on this hole.
But for those who like to live courageously,
if you're going to be going for it, you're going to be going at it with at least 3 wood, maybe even 2 iron. But all depending on the wind, most of the players would lay up on this hole, leaving themselves quite an easy approach shot into a green that's very receptible.
So is there one message David Murray is hoping his guests will leave with at the end of the round?
We hope that they leave here having experienced something that they haven't experienced anywhere else in the world. That's what we strive for, is to make an unforgettable experience at Pearl Valley Golf Estates.